Jenna.
Thanks, Vanessa. Calling all foodies, a list of New York's top restaurants is out. The Michelin guy says 5 Manhattan restaurants are 3-star dining destinations for 2020. Last week, the guide announced their more affordable bib gourmand restaurants. And for the first time, Michelin expanded their dining coverage beyond the 5 boroughs. Several restaurants in Westchester County made their list for the first time. But what do those stars and awards really mean? Joining us now is Amanda Kludt, editor-in-chief of Eater. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Okay, so the food and dining site reports on the restaurant industry and serves up their own restaurant reviews, but how valuable are these awards?
I think the Michelin stars are valuable, but it's not going to have the same influence here in New York as it does in Paris or Tokyo or cities where it's more established. New Yorkers didn't really grow up with this guide, and it's only been here for a decade or so, but it still will impact the bottom lines of these restaurants, especially the high end. So if they're dealing with expense account diners, wealthy diners, or gastro tourists who are coming from Europe or Asia to figure out where to eat in New York, they're going to use the guide, and so it's really going to help them.
Okay, we have a lot of tourists here. So.
We do.
In this age of social media and influencers, can getting or losing a Michelin star make or break a restaurant?
I think it really depends on their ambition. So if you're on the more casual, low-end side of things, if you're a neighborhood restaurant, it's more about the bragging rights, and it might bring in people, but I think it's really great for the chef's egos. But if you are at that top tier, if you're the 3-star restaurant and you lose a star, it can mean something for you in terms of tourist dollars and also your reputation in the wider restaurant industry.
And I think we have a list, so let's take a look at it. The Michelin star says these 5-star restaurants have exceptional cuisine and are worth a special journey. Chef's Table at Brooklyn Fair, 11 Madison Park, Le Bernardin, Massa, and Per Se. And then in Westchester, Blue Hill at Stone Barns earned 2 stars, becoming the first restaurant outside of the city to achieve that prestigious honor. Michelin says 2-star restaurants have excellent cooking and are worth a detour. So are there any surprises here, Amanda?
I think there's one restaurant, the Four Horsemen in Williamsburg, that was a surprise for me. It opened as a wine bar in a very casual neighborhood type of place, but over the years, it showed that it has amazing food, and so it's great to see them get this accolade from Michelin. There's a restaurant called Estella on Houston Street, and it's beloved by the food world, but never really got this star, so I think it really shows them that they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. Also, on the high end, Jean Georges lost its star last year, and it's chef and owner John George Von Drichten has said that he's going to work really hard to get it back, and he didn't do that this year. So I think he has another year of trying to get back where he started.
Absolutely. So is there a difference between getting the Michelin star and being honored with the Bib Gourmand?
Oh yeah, definitely. So the Bib Gourmand list, it's more towards more affordable fare. So you should be able to get 2 dishes and a glass of wine for under $40. Not every restaurant on that list, I think, matches that. I think sometimes you have more expensive restaurants on the list, but Michelin is kind of giving a consolation prize to these restaurants saying, hey, we see you, we appreciate you. You're not quite there yet at the 1-star level, but keep trying. Or it might just be telling the restaurants, you might not appreciate that you're off the list, but know that we went there. We didn't skip you, we didn't miss you, this wasn't an oversight, we just don't think you're quite there yet.
Okay, and then any thoughts on Westchester being a dining destination?
Yeah, absolutely. I think Blue Hill Stone Barns is one of the region's best restaurants. People in New York love it, critics love it. The fact that it wasn't on the list in previous years was almost a blind spot for Michelin. So for them to finally come around and put it on there and really give it the attention that it deserves, I think kind of corrects an imbalance in the list in previous years.
So for a foodie, where should they go?
I mean, there's so many great options. It's going to be hard to get into those 3-star places. It always is. So I think you're going to have to be planning ahead. But there are so many great restaurants on the 1-star level or on the Bib Gourmand level that people should be trying out.
All right. It sounds like I have a lot to do.
You have a long eating list.
and a lot of reservations
And a lot make. Of reservations to make.
Thank you so much, Amanda, for joining
Thank
us.
Thank you, Jenna.
Of course. The long-delayed American Dream Mall has gone through many different looks and designs. This week,